also conditional use permit, request by Courlley LLC. This one is not for a personal service shop, it's something a little more interesting. This is for high-density, multifamily residential, in the CC commercial zoning district. Number of years ago, about 8 years ago, about us, that amended its regulations to allow multifamily and CC zoning at 60 bedrooms per acre maximum as a permitted use. Anything higher than that would be a conditional use. This is the first request that goes above the 60 bedrooms per acre threshold, which sounds like a very large development, but on the contrary, it's a very small piece of property. And has all efficiency apartments rather than multi-bedroom apartments. So it's a little bit of a different animal, and it barely crosses that threshold, but it does trigger the conditional use. Subject property is located at 218 West Hill Avenue. This is on the north side of the road between Oak Street and Tomb Street. Downtown Activity Center is the character for this area east of Oak. Aerial shows really what's around it. This is the old Budget Inn Hotel. I call it sometimes the O'Connell Lodge, and I think that's what it was called 25 years ago. But it has been there more than 50 years. An old-fashioned motor court type motel that rents out motel rooms long-term. In many ways functions as an apartment complex. It is a 41-room motel. The applicant is proposing to convert it to a 37-dwelling unit apartment building with a total of 41 bedrooms. So there's no expansion to the building. It's really remodeling. Most of the motel rooms would be small efficiencies turned into efficiency apartments. Some of the larger rooms that are in the corners of the building might have a two-bedroom. So that's why the number of units does not match the number of bedrooms. In terms of population, it's really projected to be the same as it is now. Rented as apartments, very similar as it is now. But it is coming through a multi-public hearing process. Conditional use for us and City Council. They are requesting some variances for number of parking. I think impervious, which is going to the zoning board of appeals. This is also in the local historic district because there's going to be some changes to the site on the outside that requires approval from the Historic Preservation Commission. If you look carefully on this area, you see a little green patch within the subject property. That is a former pool that's to be paved over to add just a few more parking spaces there that are needed. Otherwise, it's a very tight site. Site plan looks like this, proposed to be this when they get done. Existing motel, the old motor court design from I think 1960, I think about when this was built. And then you see it's a two-story building, L-shaped, and existing pavement parking. Adjacent properties, Bangley Life Center, First Baptist Church behind it. This is the what was a halfway house for many years along Oak Street. Been empty for the past 3+ years. Across the street, you get into some of the automotive uses. This is the corner of Oak. And across the street to the south, this is a vacant lot. Some of you may remember this was the Firestone place that burned, I think, about 1999. And then the Dahlman's Diner, and the Gardy gas station on properties to the east. It's a very old, interesting area. Applicants have done this conversion in other places. This is not their first time doing it. This is an example of where they did this in Adel, where they converted a motor court motel with sort of rundown conditions into efficiency apartments. And it is quite a transformation from where it started. And that is what they're proposing to do here, to convert this motor court, sort of being used as apartments now, into an actual efficiency apartment complex. So with that, staff has found this request consistent with the comprehensive plan, the conditional use review criteria that are in your packet. We're recommending approval subject to two conditions. One is approval shall be granted for a multifamily residential development on the subject property not to exceed a maximum density of 70 bedrooms per acre. Noted in your packet, the math works out to 66.13, rounded up to 71 to make a round number, and two, in case the applicants are able to squeeze out another bedroom or two within those larger corner units, they won't have to come back through the process. This gives them just a little bit of money to expand. Number two, conditional use approval shall expire for 2 years from the date of approval. If no certificate of occupancy for the finished complex has been requested by that date. So a 2 year construction period, but I think they're very anxious to get started. Be glad to answer any questions that you might have.
Any questions for staff? In that case, we will open the public hearing portion for this case. Is there anyone here this evening that would like to speak in favor of this case? So please come forward. Please state your name and address for the record.
Commissioners, Bill Nijem, 1007 North Patterson Street. I'm here on behalf of the applicant, Courlley LLC. Thank you, Mr. Martin. Matt did a great job of putting everything in front of you. Really, like Matt said earlier, I mean, there's really no net change in terms of density. There's a 41 bedroom now. They're going to try and keep the 41 bedrooms. The change in the use from a motel to multi-family apartments, triggering this request on that. I'm happy to answer any questions y'all may have. That's the singular issue in front of the commission. Happy to answer anything else.
First of all, I think it looks awesome. It's a great idea. I'm just curious, Matt mentioned something about the fact that it does sit in a historic area and about maybe some different elevation changes. Are we going to do any elevation changes?
Yeah, and that's something we've got to address with the HPC. You know, it's tough because given what we've got to work with now, it's a concrete block, and then I believe the roof is flat. And one of the requirements we're going to have to address with the HPC is pitch roof, which I believe the ordinances may require. So it's tough to do that just because it's built right up on a property line there. And so that's one of the issues we're going to have to tackle with the HPC. I do have some pictures of the elevation. I'm happy to give y'all a pass around the proposed elevation. And then also, I think if you give the LLC pictures of the exterior of the project that the applicant just did in Adel and what it looks like now, because it's, in terms of layout, it's similar. So
that's the rendering you'll be submitting?
This is the rendering for the elevation for this project. These are the pictures for the Adel project of the exterior.
So the pitched roof is not shown there?
The pitched roof is not on there. We intend to keep the roof flat.
That's good.
Commissioners, that's actually going to be one of the variance requests with input from HPC staff is supportive of that because this is not a residential area and it's also an existing historic building.
Is this turned into like long term, not long term, but a month at a time, or is it, are you free to say if it's a month lease or yearly lease or?
I don't really think that's been determined yet. I think what they would like to see are long-term tenants. And so I think there are really two benefits to this project. Number one, it'll give this property a much-needed facelift. And number two, I do think we're looking to have some more stability, you know, with tenants. I mean, right now you've got nightly, weekly, hourly,
So Mr. Nijem, I'm assuming while you're doing this work, the people that are living there now will be have to leave for a while? Or?
So there is, it's a motel. There is, from what I understand, one tenant that's there now. He's going to be relocated within other units while they're doing the renovation.
I didn't know what your occupancy was.
In the intent, Chris, we're going to stay. I think he's been there 8 years.
So. Wow. That's a long time.
That is a long time.
Keep him around. Yeah. Any other questions for Mr. Nijem? Thank you. Thank you very much. Is there there anyone else here who would like to speak in favor of this case? Anyone here who would like to speak against this case? Please come forward. Very good. That will close the public hearing portion for this case. And I will entertain a motion. If there's no further discussion by the commission.
Chairman, reference to CU-2021-08.
Please raise your right hand. Any opposed? Likewise? The motion is carried.